Hello you guys, so today I'm gonna show you how to make this bell button notebook. So, for the materials, we're going to need paper, velvet fabric, cardboard, white glue, scissors, needle and thread, something heavy, and an X-acto knife. So, the first thing that we're going to do is fold all the pages we're going to use it up. And now I'm going to make groups of pages. I put 5 pages in each group, and I made 5 groups of pages, if that makes sense. So now I made 6 marks, 1 and 2, 6.5, 8.5, 13.5, 15.5, and 19.5. Now I'm going to make a hole in each mark with a needle, and I'm going to do this for every group of pages I make. So now I'm going to sew the book, and for that I'm going to use a piece of thread. I'm going to make a knot at the end of the thread. And do this a few times for making sure the knot is pretty big. Just like so. starting with the first group, thread the needle through the first hole and then in and out all the way through. Now for the next group of pages, I'm going to do the same. First in for the first hole, out in the second, and in here we're going to do something a little bit confusing. I'm going back to the first group of pages in a diagonal way, as you can see. Then out on the first group of pages and then in the second group of pages, so it has to look like a cross, just like so. So here's again what I did. So now I'm going to continue out on the second group of pages and again the same cross. I'm just going down to the first group of pages, making a diagonal. Out in the first group of pages, and again in the second group of pages, and now out in the second group of pages, so it has to be two crosses. And to end, we're going to make a knot. Actually, we are going to do just the same with the third group of pages. And in the first one, out in the second hole, now I'm gonna cross down to the second group of pages. Just like so. Now out on the second hole of the second group of pages. In the third hold of the third group of pages. Out in the fourth group of pages. Moving down to the second group of pages. Out in the second group of pages. And going up again in a diagonal way on the third group of pages. And ending out in the third group of pages. Now I'm making a knot again to hold all this, and I'm just going to repeat the process with all the group of pages we have. Now I have bent all the pages together. I'm going to secure them. and I'm going to use white glue to glue them all. I'm going to put some weight on it and let it dry overnight. Once it's dry, I'm going to trim the edges to make it look smoother. So for this I'm going to use a ruler and an X-acto knife or a cutter. Be careful and cut just little by little. I'm going to use this maroon paper to make the inner cover, so I'm going to fold in half. And I'm going to glue it, bind that book. Use an old paper to make sure that it's not going to transfer to the other pages. Cut the excess paper. And use sandpaper or nail sandpaper to make it smoother. Now I'm going to draw the shape of our book on a cardboard and just cut it. I'm going to need two of these to make the covers. And now it's time for the velvet. I'm going to glue some lace at the spine of the book and glue the cardboard paper to the velvet fabric, leaving 1 inch at the edges. Make sure everything is perfectly glued. Measure the spine of your book and leave that space between the covers. Cut the excess of fabric, again leaving 1 inch on the edges. So now I'm going to glue the edges, so I put white glue and fold the fabric inside. Now I'm going to use scrap paper tape to make sure the fabric doesn't come off. Now it's time to put it all together, so I put white glue to the cardboard and glue it to the group of pages we have, just like so. Now close the book and press down. Now I'm going to remove the glue residue with a wet towel. So yeah, this is all. Now we have a beautiful velvet notebook. Thank you for watching my video. I hope I explained myself well, and yeah, bye!